Well, we're here in the Archives and Special Collections Department of the University of Manitoba, and there's something special about one particular aspect of this collection, and that is the collection of T.G. Hamilton, who was a very famous figure in Winnipeg's and Manitoba's history, but he had a strange sideline.
In addition to being a well-renowned physician in the city of Winnipeg, he conducted seances within his home, where several people would join him and try and conjure spirits.
That's the woo seances.
Yes, exactly, yes.
Okay. Yeah. Why would he do these seances?
Well, most people say it's because he and his wife Lillian lost their son during the First World War in the influenza epidemic. And so they were trying to find a connection to life after death. The entire procedure, as it were, was documented, not only in photographs, but there are textual records as well.
And why would a university library bastion of knowledge and science have collections of photographs of ghosts?
Well, in addition to being, you know, an extremely popular collection because of the visual imagery in the photos, it's also an interesting social event that was happening at the time. Okay. This was almost a form of entertainment in the 1930s.
This was the 1920s and 30s version of sitcoms?
You could say that, yeah. And it's probably not as hilarious as something Ray Romano might do.
Now, in order to look at this stuff, because this is preserved and this is archival stuff, we have, I just can't reach in and...
No, we prefer that you use cotton gloves.
I get to use gloves.
Yes, that way you don't get your grimy fingerprints all over the photographs.
I look like some famous 50-year-old singer. Okay, so I put these on, and then I reach in, for example, here, and I just pull out the front one.
Right.
And it's all numbered and stuff, and the archives is amazing that it actually has neat stuff. And the first one I pull out has actually... This is it. Now they're holding hands. This is done in the dark, and the flash goes off.
Right.
And there's the medium with goop on her face.
Right.
Looks like a fried egg.
It does. So the way that the seances were set up was that Hamilton had a bank of cameras.
And we have a photograph of that.
We do, yes. Okay. And so there are multiple shots of every seance that was taken in his home because there were different camera angles for each seance.
Hmm. And what I find interesting is that this resource has been used by a lot of people.
Yes, it's probably next to the Winnipeg Tribune our most popular resource in the archives.
Even movie producers have come here.
Exactly, yeah. Hamilton has finally gone Hollywood.
And there's this movie that's coming out, Haunting in Connecticut. Mm-hmm. Not really in Connecticut, actually here in Winnipeg.
Right.
And they're recreating some of the events.
Right. Yeah, the movie was filmed in Winnipeg, and the Hamilton photograph collection was sort of used as the basis for seance photographs which appear in the film.
I've seen this kid almost every day since we've been here.
You're scaring me.
We'll join the club.
Wow. So we have all these great documents, and it's not just the photos, there's documents, there's automatic writing and all that great psychic stuff.
Yeah.
And we have the archives of this incredible collection right here at the University of Manitoba.